Hello everyone, today we will see how to do BAM tracking. First we will create a BAM activity, then we will track the messages at receive port, send port and orchestration. We will be using continuation and continuation ID to achieve it. So here is our interface which has a publisher and a subscriber. Publisher receives the order request and publishes the message after validating to the subscriber. Subscriber will transform the message to the outbound format. So let's create a BAM activity. So we'll go to add-in, then we'll create a new BAM activity. I will name it as DJ end-to-end tracking. Then I would add the milestones. Milestones are nothing but the date time. So we would have milestones for receive port start time and end time, then publisher start time and end time, then subscriber start time and end time, and send port start time and end time. Then we will do business data tracking like transaction ID, product type. Once we create the business milestone and business data, we would export the BAM activity and save it. So now we can deploy this BAM activity. So I will copy paste this activity XML into tracking folder. Then I will execute BAM deployment command to deploy it. So I will open command prompt and navigate to tracking folder under BizTalk installation directory. So once we deploy, this activity will be deployed in BAM primary import database. So where you can see the tables for active instance, completed instances. Now let us open the tracking profiler and import the BAM activity. From the right left pane we can import the BAM activity. We can search for the assembly name and apply the tracking. So let us apply tracking for publisher start time and publisher end time. I will map the complete scope. And if I need to track a data point from a shape, I can right click and choose the message payload and map it to the transaction ID. I will save the tracking profiler So let me choose a message context payload and then map the port start time and end time. So here you can search for the port name. If you are not sure which port to apply, we can go to the admin console and verify the port which is bound to the orchestration. So you can search for the ports by specifying the name. Let us do a tracking for publisher and the receive part, receive port itself. I will apply the transaction ID tracking at the receive port. Though this is a single interface, as we have not applied the continuation, we will see tracking for receive and publisher part as a two different records. Let me process a file. So here is my order request. Okay, message got processed. Let's go to the archive folder, and due to some exception, message was archived. Let us see the event logs. Okay, exception has occurred. This is because of some table name got changed. Okay, let's go to the tracking database and see the completed instance. Here we can see only receive part being tracked and we don't find the publisher part. Let's see the active instances, and here you can see the publisher part is tracked only for start time and end time has not happened because an exception has occurred, and in the exception we are terminating the process. I have corrected the table name. Let me reprocess the file again. And here you see two separate entries for receive and the publisher orchestration. So now let us apply continuation and continuation ID so that we can track the complete flow in one record. So right click on the activity name and add continuation and continuation ID. Both continuation and continuation ID should have the same name. Let us name it as transaction ID. So we will choose the message payload and search for our order request schema and map the transaction ID and associate the port that receives the message. This will be the continuation, and continuation ID will be the publisher receive shape payload. So Bistock will internally have a correlation set between the receive side and the orchestration side. So if both are matching, then it will start tracking the record as a one single tracking record. Similarly, we can apply for subscriber and even for the send port. So I have processed a file. Let's see the completed instance. Here you see like all the tracked instance are being tracked in one single tracking ID. Now let's add a continuation and continuation ID for publisher and subscriber. I will name it as PubSub trans ID. This will do the continuation between publisher and the subscriber. So I will map the transaction ID from the receive payload of the publisher. That will be the continuation, and continuation ID will be the transaction ID of the receive shape payload on the subscriber. Let me add the subscriber start time and end time. I'll map the product name from the outbound schema. I will add a continuation and continuation ID for the subscriber and the send port. So continuation will be initialized from the subscriber orchestration. I will just use the message payload on the transform shape. I'll choose a message payload and search for the outbound schema and map the continuation ID. I have to associate the port. So using message context payload, I will map the start time and end time of the send ports. So these data points needs to be associated to a send port. So you can search for the send port or just verify from the orchestration binding of the subscriber. So we will apply the ports for this start time, end time and transaction ID. Now let's deploy the tracking profiler and process an order. So order was successfully processed, and if you see the completed instance, you have the complete tracking details of receive, publisher, subscriber and the send ports. Let me process one more order with the same transaction ID. And if you see the completed instance, you can see one more tracked instance for the same transaction ID. So for each message there will be a new tracking entry.
Today we seen how to do end-to-end tracking for a particular instance interface. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching the video.